sure some of you have seen my face somewhere before. As you can see, we are a bit in a hurry. So in this 10 minutes slot, I will give you an in-depth IPv6 training. I will go through the slides like this fast training in Europe. So I will speed up my talking in hyperspeed. So sit tight. Let's go. Okay, maybe that is not going to work, so let's take the bit different approach. In the Finnish army, I learned that everything I ask, I need to give a motivation. So here's your motivation. So we are running out of the IPv4 address, and also we heard from Klaus this morning that there's a second motivation, because Klaus is asking people to do so as well. This I call the so-called fight back slide. So yes, we are running out of the IPv4 address, so meanwhile we might want to do something called NAT. There are many variations of NAT. Just to show that I'm presenting vendors, so I'm promoting products. We have a product which can actually do the different kind of NAT in one box with the quite nice scalable way. I'm not here either the promo PPP. It's just slide, summary slide of the challenges what the IPv6 also brings on the PPP side. Yeah, we are able to do that. We are also able to do the the IP world, as such, with the IPv4, IPv6, with routed access models, plus on the bridge access models. I'm not really going through in detail all of this, but as you can see that the different scenarios, what we get when we need to terminate a lot of customers with the different access networks, with the different support on the access network for the V6, we actually end up, I didn't count them, but the roughly 10 to 12 different scenarios that what you need to support. So it's getting complex. The latest, let's say, feature that we actually got, that there might actually be someone who wants to run completely IPv6 environment only, and we are talking about the trigger packets. So the latest add-on on that was is the router solicit packet. So indeed we can function only on the IPv6 log environment as well. Okay, I know. Then you start complaining that I have this pretty complex option fields that I'm actually using in my environment to identify customers and doing this and that. So we solved that problem as well. So we implemented the Python scripting capabilities in our BNG. So basically it means that we can actually take the DHCPv4 V6 packets, match whatever field on that packet, put it in information cache, we do some radius, local user database, kind of magic, and when we actually return the parameters towards the customer, we can modify, use that information from the cache, and return basically whatever we like. So we kind of like changed the approach so that we are actually developing tools in our PNG to support whatever scenario you might actually have in your network. Scalability is quite okay, so we are nowadays talking about the, let's say, 256,000 subscribers in one system, so we can almost fit the whole Finland in our biggest system at the moment. And if you do so, it might be important you actually make it redundant. This is just to show the latest what we added on the on the redundancy mechanism. It's a bit complex slide, but basically what it tells you is that the one-to-one redundancy between your BNC is always good. But if you might want a bit cheaper solution, there's like the oversubscribed multi-chassis redundancy as well. So you can use the, let's say, the one BNC system to back up your 500,000 subscribers in your network. Quite okay, I think. So to sum up, because I guess I'm a bit famous about the short presentation and the between you and your peers. We have a, let's say, the BNC solution, which is able to provide also the IPv6 capabilities with the quite scalable speed and the different access scenarios. And the yes, we can integrate some application awareness, security, NAT, video stuff on top of the our BNG.